Good morning and welcome to the Salvation Army in Bedlington and another online worship service. And this is Father's Day, so happy Father's Day to all of you fathers out there. For some, I know of at least one, this is your first Father's Day where you're a father. And so a very special happy Father's Day to you. This is a day that brings mixed feelings for a lot of different people because many of us have lost our fathers. And it can be a difficult day not having a father that you can talk to this day. For some, it's just this week that you lost your father. The Burks family has lost Major Dan Burks. And Major Dan is uncle to Major Cheryl. And that family is really feeling it. He was a really good father, great uncle, a great husband, and he's going to be missed by many. So today is a very difficult Father's Day for that family, and we wish you all the best this day. We lift you up in prayer this day. Today's message comes to us from Captain Stephanie Dennis, who is a niece of Major Dan Burks. Captain Stephanie is the administrative aide to the territorial commander of the USA West Territory. And she brings us a message today on Father's Day and talking about our Heavenly Father. And so, just now, I want to encourage you to join in as we worship our Heavenly Father. And thank you for joining us.
Did the drummer name his twin daughters?
What?
Anna 1, Anna 2.
Ha ha ha! So funny!
Dad, can you put the cat out?
I didn't know it was on fire!
How did Darth Vader know what Luke got him for Christmas?
How?
He felt his presence!
Jacob?
Yes?
Why can't you hear a pterodactyl go to the bathroom?
I don't know. Why can't you hear a pterodactyl go to the bathroom?
Because the pee is silent.
What did the police officer say to the belly button?
I don't know. What did the police officer say to the belly button?
Under a vest.
How does Darth Vader like his toast?
I don't know. How does Darth Vader like his toast?
On the dark side.
Why did the Invisible Man turn down the job offer?
I don't know. Why did the Invisible Man turn down the job offer?
He couldn't see himself doing it.
What did the pirate say on his 80th birthday?
I don't know. What did the pirate say on his 80th birthday?
I'm 80.
What's black and white and goes around and around? A penguin in a revolving door!
Does anyone need an ark? I know a guy.
Happy Father's Day, everyone!
Happy Father's Day!
Happy Father's Day!
Happy Father's Day!
Happy Father's Day, we love you!
Happy Father's Day! We love you.
Good morning. I'm really glad to have been asked to introduce this next song. It's a lovely song. I love the melody and the sentiments expressed. The song speaks very clearly to me of a father's love and of influence. Of course, we're referring to our Heavenly Father's love and his undying love and care for us. Though we make mistakes, he sings his love over and over again until it's written on our heart. The song also speaks of our responsibility to share his love and of the importance of influence. Today, I thank God for that Heavenly Father's love, but also for the influence of my earthly father, Gordon, the best of fathers. Enjoy the song.
To a thousand tongues, but there is one that sounds above them all. The Father's song, the Father's love, He sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. Heaven's perfect melody, the Creator's symphony, You are singing over me, the Father's song. It's heaven's perfect mystery, the King of love has sent for me, and now You're singing over me, the Father's song. I have heard so many songs, listened to a thousand tongues, but there is one that sounds above them all. The Father's song, the Father's love, You sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. Heaven's perfect melody, the Creator's symphony, You are singing over me, the Father's song. Heaven's perfect mystery, the King of love has sent for me, and now You're singing over me, the Father's song. Father's song, Father's love, You sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. It's written on my heart forever.
Father's Day to my dad, Brian Cuthbert, an attribute that I know that I share with him, apart from his giggle, that sounds like Muttley, his sense of humour, because we both get the fits of giggles at times, is our stubbornness, very stubborn, but he would call it determination. So I know I get that off of you, Dad, but it just means that from an early child you've taught me that whatever we want in life, do your best, and he wouldn't ask for anything more. And I love that about him. As a dad, I couldn't ask for anything more. What I would ask for maybe is not the wonky chin and the droopy eye. But I love you dearly, Dad. Mwah. Happy Father's Day.
Good morning. Richard James Byrne. Bandmaster Jim Byrne. Do you see him? I want to wish him a happy Heavenly Father's Day. It's some time since I last saw him, but his presence is always with me. I've been asked to acknowledge an attribute that has passed to me from him. From his early days, my dad committed himself to things he enjoyed, and he loved music. He passed that love of music on to me. He had a sense of humour that was special, and a self-belief, a self-confidence that influenced all he chose to do. I think I got a bit of that too. An attribute that didn't come to me, well, my dad could sing. Boy, could he sing. He sang with enthusiasm, with gusto, and he sang for the Lord. His strong tenor voice is something I would have loved to have had, but it missed me. And maybe it's passed through the generation to Stephen. That's what happens with DNA.
During lockdown, I've learnt a lot from my dad, such as mowing the lawn, which I'm really good at, and playing a bit of basketball. And I really enjoy doing those two things with him. I love you, Daddy.
To my dad, Colin Doyle, happy Father's Day. It's been a while since we spent a Father's Day together, but growing up and since, I've seen you care for others, especially those that can't stand up or support themselves. And I guess that's in part why I'm here in Malden serving God and the Salvation Army. They also asked me what I wish you hadn't passed on, and to be honest, it's about as obvious as the nose on my face, but then you got that from your dad too. Have a great day, and I hope to see you soon.
Happy Father's Day, Dad. I've been told many times I'm a lot like my dad. Two things I know I've inherited from him are our thoroughness in completing jobs and tasks and our love to travel. And I've been lucky enough to vacation a lot with my mom and dad. My dad is a very fair man and giving of his time. And that's two attributes that I strive to have that are like my dad. An attribute he has that I wish I have, and I know there's not much hope I'll ever be like this, but is to be handy and to be able to do home renovations like he does. Happy Father's Day again, Dad. I love and miss you very much. Thank you for all you still do for me, and I can't wait to see you and Mom again soon.
Do I communicate your love?
Jesus, Jesus in me.
I just want to say Happy Father's Day. I love you loads. I think you're amazing. I feel like I've inherited your lovely, caring, kind nature and your friendliness. And I've also inherited the light in your nose, which I've learned to love, and your bull in a china shop nature as well. I can't wait to see you later on. I absolutely love you loads.
Hi folks, greetings from Wiltshire. We're living through some challenging times at the moment, aren't we? But one of the silver linings for me has been the opportunity to join in worship each Sunday and see so many family and friends from the core sharing their thoughts and prayers for one another. I've inherited so many traits from my dad, most of them positive, though you might need to have a word with Victoria and Constance about my fashion sense. Apparently shorts in December coupled with socks and slippers isn't a good look. Amongst the positive traits I've acquired would be his determination and his commitment, although Victoria would tell you this constrained the realms of stubbornness at times. But like Dad, I never do things by halves. If I agree to do something, I always turn up and I give of my best, with the Byrne family motto ringing in my ears. Remember who you are and what you represent. I have to confess, there were times where as bandmaster's son, where I questioned his ethic, particularly during carol playing season, when the expectation was that even though the band was split into shifts, we'd be there for the duration. I'm also grateful for inheriting the trait from him of always being interested in helping others, particularly in terms of their ability to learn and develop. And I guess that it's this, coupled with the love of the outdoors and adventure, which I also inherited from him, I've got that to thank for the career I have in teaching and my role as an outdoor education advisor with Wiltshire Council. I'm sure if he were here now, he'd be proud, but he'd be regularly giving me the benefit of his wisdom. The fulfillment I get from working with others, helping children and young people learn more about themselves and their place in the world, is testimony to both the nature and the nurture I received from him and my mum. I have to confess that I talk to my dad every day, even though it's 8 years since he was promoted to glory. But on this particular Sunday, I wanted to take the opportunity to wish Ian Byrne a happy Heavenly Father's Day from his number one son.
Happy Heavenly Father's Day, Dad, otherwise known as Joe Wearmouth. One thing I got from you was a love of laughter, but I wish I had your ability to tell a good or a bad joke. The thing I wish I hadn't got from you was being stubborn, but I'll always be grateful that I had a loving Christian dad. Love you, Dad. Happy Father's Day.
Most people know that my dad's really good with computers, and one day I'd like to be as good, almost as good as him. Also, and one thing I have got from him is freakishly long shins. He's lucky he's grown into his. Hopefully I will.
On this day, I reflect about the attributes I've inherited from my dad, Major Ken Morey. It's certainly not his love of politics. He loved the countryside and especially walking in the beautifully created world he often preached about. An activity I still enjoy today, and even more so during these days of isolation. The greatest characteristic I inherited from Major Ken was his keen business acumen, which helps me in my role as general manager of a Christian conference centre. I'm grateful for the influence and lifestyle of my earthly father, who helped shape me to the person I am today. Thank you, Major Ken, now in heavenly love abiding.
An attribute I've definitely picked up from my dad would be the lightly nose. Cheers for that, Dad, thank you. On a more serious note though, when I think of my dad, I often think of him doing jobs behind the scenes, jobs that often go unnoticed, but make a big difference to people. I would like to think I've got some of that in me too. From an attribute which I would have liked to have picked up from my dad, it would have to be his love for gardening. As you can see, my garden is a little overgrown. Well, I'm sure his, after a time of lockdown, will be spotless as usual. Happy Father's Day, Dad. Love from us all. Thanks for all you do for us.
One of the gifts that I received, I think, from my dad is an appreciation of trying new things and maybe stepping out of your comfort zone and broadening your horizons. And I think, in a way, the Sunday online services have allowed us to do that. The Salvation Army has always learned new music, and this arrangement has allowed us to just try something new, to slot in some new songs, which would maybe be more modern, along with our hymns, for an idea that we would have some blended worship and we would learn some new music. And there's some great songs out there. We're going to hear a song called Good Good Father, given to us by Chris Tomlin. One of the lines of the song that's repeated says, "You are perfect in all of your ways." I'm so grateful that in this imperfect world that we live in, we have a perfect Heavenly Father who loves us, and I can't do anything to destroy that love. That love is constant, and that is a wonderful lesson to me this Father's Day.
Good,
that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, 'cause you know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm in love by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Because you are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. You are perfect in all of your ways. Oh, you're perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. Oh, it's love so undeniable. I can hardly speak. Peace so unexplainable. I can hardly think as you call me. Deeper still as you call.
Happy Father's Day, Pops. A couple of things that I love about my dad is that he's very loyal to his friends and he's extremely generous, especially with his time, and generous in ways that often go unnoticed or in ways that he chooses to hide. My dad has passed on to me a love of spending time with my family, and I like nothing better, and neither does he. He has taught me through his love and support how important family is, and both him and my mum are the best examples to me as they continue to show that love and support to us and to each other. And they have built a strong Christian family, and I hope to follow in his footsteps. One thing my dad has passed on to me is a weird laugh. He laughs like Muttley. I laugh rather weirdly and loudly, and once we both get going, we find it hard to stop. Dad, you know there are no words to express exactly how we feel about you, but I'm truly blessed to have George Brian Dixon as my dad.
Happy Father's Day, Dad. I'm so grateful that you are my father, and I do think we share a few things in common. I've received your gift of being a people person, which I appreciate a lot. I think we have a decent sense of humour, and that's always been useful and good fun. And you've given us wonderful independence. Even when we were across the sea, we always felt supported, and I always felt that you had my back. A couple of things that I don't share in common with you is I'm not very handy in the garden. I do not have green thumbs or fingers or toes, so that's still to be worked on. And I probably procrastinate more than you do, but if I'm half the dad that you are with my three little super beebs, then I would have done a good job. Love you, and thanks for everything.
Hello, a few words from me here in Oslo. It's really warm, it's about 30 degrees summer here. It's not very easy in few words to say something about my dad, especially in English, but I will try just to a few words. What I remember most about him when I think back is the fact that he always managed to show us that he loved us. He loved us, we knew that, but he also showed it a lot. You could always see in his eyes that he lit up and smiled, and he was very loving in all his connection with us, and that is something I'm very grateful for. He was very loud sometimes, he had the strong opinions and meanings, and I was very shy and quiet compared to him. And this was a difference that I often was very irritated that he was always very visible, he was never quiet. But I have also learned from him that I have to stand up for my beliefs and my thoughts, and that's something to have to remember. I don't really know what more to say, but one funny thing is that I have inherited from him is that he was always on time, irritating always on time, and I'm the same. I always have to wait for people, and that's quite annoying too. He was very punctual. But he gave us a lot, and I don't think I want to say more now because I cannot. Explain. But he was a good father, and I'm very thankful.
I'd like to wish my dad a very happy Father's Day, and hope you have a great day, and hopefully see you soon. One thing that I think I've inherited from my dad would be the love of music.
So here's a message for my dad, Ray Hutchinson. Surprise! Happy Father's Day. Being asked to just say a couple of things about your attributes that you've maybe given me and some that you haven't. I think probably some of the attributes that you've passed on are, I would hope, a good work ethic and always wanting to do the right thing and to work hard and be honest, and a blueprint for how to be a good parent to me. And the boys, of course, and the Gavin. So other attributes that I haven't probably got from you is, thankfully, your hair and your ability to tell really bad jokes. But anyway, happy Father's Day. We all love you. We haven't seen as much of you lately as we normally would. And you're probably quite glad about that, but we're certainly not. So happy Father's Day, and we'll see you soon. Have a good day. Love you. Bye.
I give thanks for my father and all the father figures in my life, and people have led me on a spiritual journey through their own experience of God. I'm reminded and thankful of a God who we can cry out and call to as Dad, Daddy, Abba Father, and one who has sought after us. And I'm always reminded what God has done for us. And therefore, I give thanks in my prayer, and just pray that can be known to all. Also, I'm reminded that we think about God's toolkit, and I'm thankful to God, and we rest on his word to say, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. And I pray that as our hearts are changed and pure to be like his through the Spirit, that we can see God and live that out. I'm also reminded in the Bible it says, whatever is pure, whatever is right, whatever is noble, to think upon those things. And I pray at this time when there is difficulties in the world, that people might think of those things and reflect through themselves, so that they might be Christ-like in all their ways. So we pray for that, to be like our Christ-like Father.
Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for that guidance and direction you give to our lives each and every day. Thank you for equipping us with the tools to be able to face any situation. We pray a special thanksgiving today for the father figures in our life. I thank you that you've blessed me with many good, strong Christian influences in my life. I pray too that I can continue that legacy to my children and anyone else I come in contact with. Amen.
And Lord, we come to you right now with so many things to thank you for. We thank you for creation and all the blessings that you've given to us each and every day. And we thank you for the sunshine and for the wind through the trees and the songs of the birds and so many things that remind us of your love and your unconditional love to us. Lord, we thank you for the various gifts that you've given each of us. Lord, we each work alongside each other in the ministry that is the Salvation Army. And Lord, I thank you that each one of us have a place in that ministry. Lord, we thank you for the gifts and for the various avenues of service that you provide. Lord, we love you and we praise you for all things, and we ask that even at this time of social distancing, that you would continue to be with us, that you would bless us and help us to serve and provide for the needs of those around us. In thy name we ask these things. Amen.
Lord, as we gather in worship, wherever, whenever, and however that may be, we pray for a real blessing of the Holy Spirit, that you would rain down upon us and flood us with your grace and your mercy. We pray that we would see in ourselves the gifts that you have given us, and we pray that we would have eyes that are open to your way, ears that are open to your voice, and hearts that are open to your indwelling. Lord, let us not look to each other and the gifts we see around us so that we feel inadequate or shortchanged, but rather let us celebrate our unique abilities, our individual characters, and the varied paths that lead us to your way. Let us support one another to be the best we can be, to each show your love and each build your kingdom through the power and the gifts that we have been given. Lord, it is for your kingdom we pray, for your will to be done here in this place, wherever that may be for each of us. And we pray these things in the name of the Lord who created all things, in the name of the Messiah who lived, died, and rose again, that we may have eternal life with you, and in the name of the Holy Spirit that fills us with your great and almighty power. Bless us all now and always. Amen.
Thank you.
scripture this morning is from 1 Corinthians 12, verses 4 through 7. There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them, and in everyone, it is the same God at work. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good.
Good morning. It's my honor to speak to you this day, on this special day when we celebrate fathers and father figures in our lives. One of the things that I've enjoyed the past few months is the opportunity to worship literally around the world. And I just wanted to say thank you this morning to Bedlington and to your ministry. I've greatly enjoyed worshiping with you. And I just wanted to take this opportunity to thank you. I am a visual learner, and I believe that Jesus taught parables for people like me. I grasp concepts better. I am better able to understand and apply things to my life when I can see them and touch them and experience them myself. So this morning, I thought I might share God's word in a little bit of a different way through an object lesson. And I've chosen to speak about God's toolbox. Appropriate for Father's Day, don't you think? I would like to suggest that the church is God's toolbox. And there are many different kinds of tools in his toolbox, and each one has a specific purpose. Some things that I'm going to talk about this morning you would expect to find in your toolbox. Others you probably wouldn't think to put in your toolbox, but they are tools nonetheless. So first of all, for 1 Corinthians 12, 4 through 6 reads like this. There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but the same God works all of them in all men. So the first object lesson that, the first object that I would like to talk about is the hammer. Now we all know that this is used to build things up. Ephesians 4:29 says, "Do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen." God has created some of us to build others up, to encourage and uplift those who are struggling and going through a difficult time. I think, too, that sometimes God allows us to experience certain things so that we can, in turn, share our experiences with others. We can empathize with them. We can talk about how God helped us through that situation and, in turn, encourage them to trust him and to turn to him in their own life. Another tool, a screwdriver. Now, this is used to bind things together. Colossians 3:14 says, "And over all these virtues put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity." There are those who are gifted in the area of making peace, of genuinely loving others and bringing unity into the midst of strife. These are the people that we turn to when we need peace in our lives because they're in turmoil, or when we need a mediator, someone who can be objective and see more than one side. Another tool, it's a potato peeler. I bet you wouldn't think to find this in your toolbox, and yet it is a tool used in the kitchen. Colossians 3:8-10 we read these words. But now you must also rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in knowledge in the image of its creator. You know, there are those who are gifted with the truth. They can share the truth. They can peel back the layers of deceit and lies and break down the walls that we build to protect ourselves from the world and all of the pain that is possible in it. But this tool, this person has the ability to just speak truth into situations and to peel back all of the deceit and the lies that we so often hear and even tell in our own lives. So the next tool, another kitchen tool, is a whisk. Now, 2 Corinthians 9:2 says, "For I know your eagerness to help, and I have been boasting about it to the Macedonians, telling them that since last year you in Achaia were ready to give, and your enthusiasm has stirred most of them to action." You know, we have experienced a lot of unrest the past several weeks. Protests are being held to speak against social injustice, and they appear to be so rebellious. But without this kind of person, the person who is Christ-centered and who is fighting against the injustice, not just fighting for the opportunity to fight, but without this kind of person, there would be no change in the world. Those who are willing to stir things up without counting the cost, to right the wrongs of social injustice, what would the world be like without them? Another tool that you probably would not find in your toolbox or even in the kitchen is a pen. 1 John 5:12 through 14 says, "I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, so that you may know that you have eternal life. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us." You know, the letters written in God's word not only give a historical account of the Jewish journey, but they provide us with answers to some of life's questions. Though we may see some of us may not have the opportunity to read the Bible or to know the Bible, but those of us who have are living the example of Christ, have God's word written in our hearts, we are God's word to the world. When you look at them, you see Christ. His word is written in their hearts, and they're an open book revealing God's love and the plan that he has so carefully prepared for all of those who are willing to accept it. Now, recently I had the opportunity to use a drill to hang some curtains in my living room. And I have to admit, I think I know the attraction to power tools. And I've talked about different kinds of tools that God has in his toolbox, but I would like to close by talking about an important tool that we should have in our toolbox. It can be considered a power tool. Colossians 1:27 through 29 says, "To them God has chosen to make known among the Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. He is the one we proclaim, admonishing and teaching everyone with all wisdom, so that we may present everyone fully mature in Christ. I would like to suggest that the power tool that we could have in our toolbox is this, God's Word. You know, with this tool, we can find everything we need. Wisdom, guidance, encouragement, comfort. This could be considered our power tool. And it is through reading, learning, and applying God's Word that we can become mature in Christ. None of these tools are helpful if they remain in the toolbox. They all need to be used, to be taken out and used daily. And so I would encourage you, just in closing, to use them. Whatever God has gifted you to do, do it. And God will bless you and those that you minister to. Happy Father's Day, and God bless you.